Fundamental analysis studies a company's financial strength by using financial tools such as ratios to identify risk levels, assess its value and potential for future growth. However, the numbers do not tell the whole story. It is just a starting point to help investors narrow down their search among the many valuable stocks to a few preferred ones. Fundamental analysis is more than just analyzing the numbers. There are other non-financial aspects to consider, such as the quality of management and industry competitiveness and economic changes that can influence the numbers and trends they represent should also be considered. Please note that it is not enough to conclude by just looking at financial statements and reports, because past performance does not reflect future performance. Also, remember to consider your personal risk preference before making a decision. Types of information: economic and current events include background and focus data related to economic, political, and social trends on local and global skills. Industry and company investors use such information to assess the outlook for a given industry or a specific company. Information on alternative investment vehicles includes background and focus data on real estate, private equity, or commodities price information. These includes price quotations on investment securities and the recent price behaviors of the security, information on personal investment strategies. This information tends to be educational or analytical rather than descriptive. Which data to analyze to determine the value of a company? The following data are taken into consideration: economic analyses, industry analysis, company analysis, and economic analysis. Stock prices are heavily influenced by the state of the economy and by economic events. Generally, stock prices tend to move up when the economy is strong, and they move down when the economy starts to weaken. The economic analysis consists of a general study of the prevailing economic environment on a global and domestic basis. Such analysis is meant to help investors gain insight into the underlying conditions of the economy and the potential impact it might have on the behavior of stock prices. Leading indicators change direction in advance of turning points and are useful for forecasting while they predict direction. Leading indicators do not predict the magnitude of upturns or downturns. Coincident indicators move approximately with the business cycle, while lagging indicators change direction after turning points, suggesting that they helped confirm rather than predict those turning points. Industry analysis sets the stage for a more thorough analysis of individual companies and securities. Clearly, if the outlook is good for the industry, then the prospects are likely to be favorable for many of the companies that make up that industry. Moreover, industry analysis also helps the investor assess the riskiness of a company and therefore define the appropriate risk-adjusted rate of return to use in setting a value on the company's stock in industry analysis. The first step is to establish the competitive position of a particular industry to others. And the second step is to identify companies within the industry that holds particular promise. Normally, an investor can gain valuable insight about any industry by seeking answers to the following questions. What is the nature of the industry? How significant are technological developments? What role does labor play in the industry? Which economic forces are especially significant to the industry? What are the significant financial and operating considerations? Basic forces that determine industry profitability, rivalry among existing competitors. The intensity of rivalry influences prices, product development, advertising, workers and etc. The rivalry is more intense when there are many companies of relatively equal size competing in the industry. Slow economic growth will cause competitors to fight for market share. The threat of new entrants places limits on prices and shifts the investment required to deter new entrants. High barriers to entry include low current prices relative to costs, large capital expenditures, substantial economics of skill, or the need for extensive distribution channels to compete. Also, government policy can limit the number of competitors by imposing licensing requirements or limiting access to materials. For example, the stringent requirements to obtain a banking license or the expensive infrastructure required to provide telecommunication services. The threat of substitute products. Limit the profit potential of an industry because they limit the prices. Companies in an industry can charge. For example, the airfare from Singapore to Kuala Lumpur is expected to be lower. Given the proposed high-speed train connecting the two cities, bargaining power of buyers can influence the profitability of industry since they can price it down or demand higher quality or more services by bargaining among competitors. Buyers have more bargaining power when they purchase a large volume relative to the sale of the supplier. For example, travel agencies have to price their tour packages competitively as consumers tend to compare for the best deal. Companies will have to constantly design new itineraries to explore new attractions or offer unique services to remain profitable. Bargaining power of suppliers can also alter future industry returns if they increase prices or change the quality or services they provide. Suppliers have more bargaining power if there are few or if there are more concentrated than the industry to which they sell to, or if suppliers provide critical inputs to several industries for which few, if any, substitute exists. For example, oil and coal companies. Company analysis involves studying the financial statements of a company to learn how financial numbers are generated. The investor uses financial ratios to learn how the company is faring. The financial statements reveal the hard facts about a company's operating performance and financial position. There are three parts to a company's financial statements, and they are typically presented in this order: the income statement, profit and loss statement, balance sheet, and the cash flow statements measure the company's revenue, expenses and profits over some time. The balance sheet presents a company's financial position. At the end of a specified date is a snapshot of the company's financial position at a point in time. It summarizes the company's assets, liabilities, and shareholders' equity at a specific point in time. These three balance sheet segments give investors an idea as to what the company owns and owes, as well as the amount invested by shareholders. The cash flow statement shows how funds were raised and used. Cash flow is the lifeblood of the company for a healthy company. Their primary source of cash flow is earnings. The balance sheet, profit and loss statements are normally based on the accrual method of accounting, in which the revenues and expenses are recognized as they occur rather than when cash changes. The main advantage of accrued method of accounting is that it allows the matching of revenues and expenses in the period in which a sale occurred to appropriately measure profit, but the disadvantage is that no adequate attention is directed to the actual cash flow position of the company. The cash flow statement addresses these issues by translating profit and loss statement and balance sheet data into cash flow information. The three primary sections of the cash flow statement: cash flow from operating activities, cash flow from investing activities, and cash flow from financing activities. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, and comment below to let us know what other topics you are interested in.